session agenda.
Question, make a motion. Second.
Second.
I'll vote for it. I'll vote for it.
Thank you. This time we'll have our invocation led by Father Vargas of Good Samaritan Catholic Church. Thank you, Father Vargas.
In the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we invite you to be part of this meeting. We invite you to guide us. Find the best ways for our kids, our children in this town. Thank you for your blessing, your presence, your love, your mercy. Thank you, Lord. Bless us and keep us in your love always. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Please stand and join us.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
This time we'll have our presentations and recognition. Mitchell, come up and introduce us to the wrestlers from Clear Creek Middle School.
Yes, tonight we are excited to recognize the CCNS wrestlers, and at this time, Coach Blanton's going to come up and share a little bit about their accomplishments.
Glad to be here. We've got a real special group of young men and women this year. We've got a few that weren't able to make it, soccer games, those kinds of things. But we had a really exciting year. Came up short for a few of our goals. Mountain League, duels, we came in third place. We lost to the first place team by one match. Traditionals, we came in fourth. We were still missing several kids due to sickness, illness, and the holidays. We went down to Tifton. We competed in the middle school state duels. We were a top eight finisher. Really exciting year. So we're glad to have some strong community support, strong group of parents, as you see. It takes a village. We're very fortunate. This time I'm going to call up our wrestlers, and I will go over their Mountain League placements. First up, Braylon Nelson, placed third at 94 pounds. Come on up, Braylon. Next up, we've got Carter Ortiz, placed second at 102 pounds. Next up, Manny Velasquez was not able to make it. He was one of our champions at 118 pounds. Next up, we've got Bo Cronick. He placed second at 132 pounds. Next up, we've got Isaiah Goodwin. He placed third at 139 pounds. Next up would be Angel Garcia. He's playing with the boys soccer team tonight. He got fourth at 147 pounds. Next up, we've got Piper McCormick, placed fourth at 165 pounds. The night before we had our team duel, she actually beat the kid that won first on Saturday from Union County. Just couldn't quite pick it back up on Saturday. Tremendous efforts. Next up, we've got Denny Ramirez, who placed first at 210 pounds. Finally, we've got John Oliver, who placed fourth at 275 pounds. I'd like to say we've got a lot of first-year wrestlers on the team this year. We had 67 at one point. A lot of kids. I wish they could all be here tonight to be recognized. They came to practice every day, worked hard, and we were very pleased.
Coach, you want to see them in the picture?
Yes, ma'am. our guys.
All parents get one? Thank you.
Thank you very much, Coach. Appreciate all your hard work. It's all your hard work. Look forward to all the future state championships that are going to bring on, I'm sure. All right, public participation. At this time, we'll take a quick pause in case you don't want to hear the rest of the day.
Dicey time.
Under public participation, we've had no one sign up today, so we'll move on to the consent agenda. On the consent agenda, we have the minutes from 1:24:22 work executive session and 1:27:22 regular session, and you have to say no about field trips that were attached to the packets on Monday night. This time, I recommend you approve the consent agenda as presented.
Have a motion?
I'll make a motion.
Second?
Second.
I'll vote for it. I'll vote for it.
Superintendent's report. We have personnel and annual school personnel renewals. The personnel, start with it. There was a couple of changes. You'll notice the things in yellow added since Monday. You guys have any questions?
The ones in yellow that added declassified resignations, two classified hires. So we can talk about the everybody need to go to the legal session. We can talk about something. Talk about the new people that are here. Everybody good with it?
Yeah.
No. Let's go over it.
All right. Well, then I recommend you approve the personnel agenda as approved.
I have a motion.
Second.
I'll bar. I'll bar.
Next, moving on to annual student personnel renewals. Put it in your packet. We'll start with the individuals. B the immediate family members of our board members. We have Candy Davis, recommend approval for employment for the FY23 school year.
Have a motion?
Motion.
Make a motion. Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
Next one is fair.
Yep. Next we have Ms. Donna Parks, recommend her for employment for the FY23 school year.
Have a motion?
I make a motion.
Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
Abstain.
One is fair.
Next we have Jill Parks, recommend her for employment for the FY23 school year.
Have a motion?
Motion.
I'll second it. All for?
All for.
Abstain.
One is fair.
Next we have Darcy Pritchett, recommend her for employment for the FY23 school year.
Motion?
I make a motion.
Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
Abstain.
And finally, Tina Watkins, I recommend her for employment. FY23.
Motion.
I recommend her for employment for FY23.
Okay, do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion.
Second.
Second.
All those in favor?
That's fair.
Next we'll move on to the Larry Walker Center staff. See the list. We have no objections, we can do them all at once.
Everybody find them up?
Okay.
Good.
Yes, sir.
That's good.
Okay. I'll make a motion, or recommend the Larry Walker Educational Center staff for employment for FY23.
Motion?
I make a motion.
Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
The rest of the schools are listed by school. The only thing that you might want to note is that the MIP staff are included on the high school list just for the minutes. Alright. I recommend the Clear Creek Elementary School staff for employment for FY23 as listed on the agenda.
Motion?
Motion.
Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
I recommend the LJ Elementary staff for employment for FY23 school year as listed on the agenda.
Motion?
Motion.
I'll second it. All for?
All for.
I recommend the Mountain View Elementary staff for employment for FY23 school year as listed on the agenda.
Motion?
Motion.
Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
I recommend the Clear Creek Middle School staff for employment for FY23 school year as listed on the agenda.
Motion?
Motion.
Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
And finally, I recommend the DHS MIP staff for employment for FY23 school year as listed on the agenda.
Motion?
Motion.
Second?
Second.
All for?
All for.
Thank you, gentlemen. We'll move on to operational effectiveness. This time, we need to select a legislative delegate and alternate. Annually, the Georgia School Board Association requires a delegate nomination from districts. School boards across the state are asked to nominate a delegate to represent his or her board. Propose changes to the 2023 GSBA legislative positions if they wish to do so. So, Mr. Chairman, you can take nominations, I suppose.
Off the board. Any volunteers? Who's got the time to do it? Doug?
Doug didn't pass, unless somebody else has a burning desire.
No, I don't have a burning desire. I'm gonna make the.
I'll second.
Call.
Second.
All of it? He is, my former, they all of it?
Yeah, that's fine.
Am I good with that? Alright, I'm gonna make my, Grandma's office.
Second.
All for?
All for.
Alright, under policies, our first read on January 24th, second read February 14th. That includes policy AFC, emergency closings, there are no changes. Policy CMA, administrative rules will be rescinded due to legal recommendation. Policy DFK, gifts and bequests. Any changes are based on GSBA legal counsel recommendation. Basically, the main one is that we're prohibiting the soliciting for crowdfunding. That's the main change to the policy. And finally, policy GCRA 1, drug screening for bus drivers, no changes. If there are no questions, concerns, or comments, I make a recommendation that you accept these policies as they were.
I have a motion.
I'll make a motion.
Second.
Second.
I'll vote. I'll vote.
Under fiscal accountability, we have the finance reports presented to you on Monday. If there are no questions, concerns, I recommend you accept them as presented.
Motion.
Motion.
Second.
Second.
I'll vote. I'll vote.
Finally, under superintendent's announcements and comments, I just wanted to make mention that we are in the process of staffing for all schools. For the FY 23 school year, we got letters of intent back early in the week, and we are calculating how many positions we may or may not need to fill. And we're even out everything at every school and make sure that we're getting things in place to recruit some new folks. And to that end, we have job fair scheduled for March 2nd from 4 to 7 here at the ATO. I encourage anybody who's interested in employment at Gilmer County Schools to come out and be part of that job fair. We may be hiring some people on the spot. Finally.
Can I have a question?
Yes, sir.
We just know them all the people. Like, that's laying, they can still get. Probably, we spoke on music. We know them all these people who just come back.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to. They still got a chance to get out of it. They still their intent, they wanted to come back in.
Oh, if they saw their intent, they're on that list.
Oh.
If they didn't,
okay.
Yeah.
All right.
That's how we know. All right, finally, we have our charter discussion led by Mr. Pritchett. And in the spirit of continuing our board's effort to continually improve governance practice, Mr. Pritchett will continue our monthly board training, focus on the charter of Gilmer County Schools. Board members will have the opportunity to ask questions or request clarification from myself or the district staff. Mr. Pritchard.
You know, if you really listen.
No.
Last month we discussed section 17, business control. This month we're going to review sections 24 and 25, transportation and food services. Charter system and each charter system school shall comply with all applicable laws governing transportation and students. The charter system and each charter school system shall comply with all applicable laws governing food service for students. Now, these are short statements, but it gives us a good idea of how much flexibility we have in those 2 years. Any questions about that? That is this month's topic.
The two very short statements, but you know, our charter allows us a lot of flexibility from Title 20 of the Georgia Code, but when it comes to transportation and food service, we are not exempt from those applicable laws and any federal statutes that apply.
So, no question. Give an example. Hmm? Give an example of some of the laws that.
Okay, like the DOT rules that, like speed limit. Right. So, if we were completely exempt from all laws, our buses could speed.
Okay.
All requirements that other school systems have to have for safety inspections for buses and that sort of thing, we have to do that. We can't waive those things. All right. If there are no further items, I recommend we adjourn.
I have a motion to adjourn.
I make a motion.
Second.
Second.
I'll vote. I'll vote. Yay.